Thanks very much, Richard. I don't see too many familiar faces in the room here, but that's probably for the reason that I mainly manage the forest research side, but I do dip in and out of all aspects every so often. So that's my role in the department. And just to go through some of the topics that we have it broken down into, I suppose there's four main items there. There's environmental and climate smart approaches to the agri-food system, there's animal production and health and welfare, there's growth, rural growth, digitization and bioeconomy, and then food. So they're all pillars unto themselves, and then we have the rapid response research, which is cross-cutting, but it's targeted at a more rapid turnaround, and so it's more desk studies and small projects is where we're targeting those. So of those, and just to talk a little bit about co-funds, DIRA is open to co-funds, and that means that Northern Ireland participation is possible. I should just note as well, it's between instruments 2 to 6, and on the topics that are there within our call spec, we have 6 in A1 and 5 in A2, 2 in A3 and 5 in A4, and then of course in the rapid response they nominated 2 as well. So that means that it's it has extra capacity there through the Northern Ireland participation. And then maybe to take a look at our funding instruments, we have, I've broken it down, it's 3 pillars here. And of course the ones in gold or orange or whatever colour is coming out on the screen there aren't open to Northern Ireland, but the blue ones are. And then the text in white is open to 1 or more RPO, so that means that it can be just a sole RPO, but of course we encourage collaboration, so we might want to bear that in mind as you're writing proposals. So we have 3 pillars. The first one I'll talk a little bit about is the Research Plus. It's aimed at small projects that DAFN has funded and they're near completion, and it's about bringing it on to that extra TRL so that it's heading in the direction of funding from Enterprise Ireland. So it's about bringing it to about bringing it to market and how we're going to do that. So it's a 1-year duration and it's €100,000. So it's really designed as a top-up to projects that have commercial potential. And again, it's not open to DIRA co-funding. Then if we look at the, I suppose these will be our traditional that most will be familiar, these funding instruments that we have, 2 to 5. We have the desk study, involving 1 or more RPOs. That's a grant request of equal to less than 150,000, so in the DIRA co-funding. We have small projects, that I suppose the differentiation there is it requires experimental research. Again, it's open to 1 or more RPO. It's 2-year duration, €250,000, and it is open to DIRA as well. We have the standard project. This it requires 2 or more RPOs, and has a 4-year duration, €600,000, and open to DIRA. So that's starting to get into this higher level of research and more collaboration, and of course the expense of the project has to be reflected in collaboration and the scientific excellence in there as well. As you go forward, it gets more difficult, I suppose. The large project then, that's open to, has to be at least 3 or more RPOs, accounting for at least 10% of the overall grant. So that's just nobody just put in there. They need to have more than 10% for it to be a realistic representation of their participation. That is open to 4 years of funding, 1.25 million. Again, DIRA are open on that from the instrument. Then if you look at the 5 and 6, seven projects, instruments. We have two there. We have the programme, which is open to Dear Hope. This is a large strategic initiative involving collaboration with at least four RPOs. And again, it's the 10% requirement there. It's open to 5 years and with grant funds of 3 million. So that's a very large amount of money that's available there, and it's addressing, I suppose, cross-cutting areas and areas of strategic importance. Then we have the innovation platform, and in some ways it's quite different in the funding and the duration. It has more of an industry orientation to it. So you have to have at least four RPOs, again with 10% requirement for each one, and there has to be at least three industry partners accounting for at least 30% costs, and 10% must be in cash. So that's quite an ask. It is a big project, it's a lot of money, and it's also open for 5 years. So that, of course, is not open to Dear Hope funding. So that's answering really big questions, and value for money is definitely an issue there, and ensuring that scientific excellence and value for money are represented quite well. And of course, I should say that these are two-stage applications. So an initial expression of interest should be submitted on the deadline, which is the 18th of April. These will be evaluated alongside the other projects that come in. And when the application is successful, we'll notify the party, and we'll give further guidance. But the budget for that will come not from this year, but most likely from next year. So that's the two-stage application process there. Of course, you're aware that it's all up on our website, the call spec and the call guidelines. I'd encourage everybody to read them and to read them together. And of course, this year is our first year, but we'll be doing it through Flexi Grant, and Rory will go through Flexi Grant and do a small one through on it as an example. We have used it, we've tested it, we've had RPOs use it, and it's so far so good. So we're quite happy with the way it's progressing at the moment. And then, of course, the closing date, the all-important closing date, is the 18th of April, 1 o'clock. So, evaluation criteria for instrument one, which is the Research Plus, has to have the freedom to operate, has to be ambitious with its innovation potential. They're marked out of 1 to 10. The potential future for commercialization, so how likely is this to get to market, how near it is, and the impact on the agri-food and forest industry, so is it going to have a large impact, or is it going to be somewhat lesser? Potential has to be weighed up there and proven. And then, of course, track record and commercialization will come into it as well. So the fact that we can prove that this is going to happen. And then for the, I suppose, our traditional funding instruments, the 2 to 7. So relevance and impact, again, marked out of 10, it's important to express that, how this is going to affect the markets, how it's going to affect policy and the implications there. So on scientific excellence, it has to be greater than 60% to be put forward for further evaluation, the quality, efficiency of implementation, including costs, so how much it's going to cost and how it's going to be engaged on comes into it as well. And I should also say that overall it has to be a minimum of 60% to be put forward for further consideration. So it's a minimum of 60% in scientific excellence and a minimum of 60% to be put forward. Then the evaluation process, we have a three-step evaluation process. Initially, you'll come into us, into DAFM, through the Flexi Grant, and we'll focus on, I suppose, the smaller details in it, or maybe the larger, whichever way you look at it. Are the RPOs photos and register with us. It's everything in line and eligible with costs. Then subject to that, and usually we find that everything is okay there. Generally, it's just an issue looking at eligibility really. Going on from that, then we have the expert evaluation. So we have expert panels meet, and we recognised academics, industry, and public representatives that sit down and evaluate the panel, and we come to a consensus on the projects, and the scores are allocated. Then, following on from that, it goes to the DACM Research Committee. This is a high-level committee with public representatives and industry representatives, and they will discuss the strategic importance of projects and put those forward for recommendations to be put in place for funding. And of course, we will be looking at the two-stage applications there, and they will be asked for, they'll be re-invited to submit, and then proposals that they had started on FlexiCount can be the basis of their application in the future. The awarding. So all coordinators will be, all coordinators of successful proposals will be notified of the award, or the award potential, I should say. Include experts, panel, and staff and research committee recommendations in the revised proposals. So the recommendations from the DACM committee and the expert panel will be noted and put back to the coordinators, so they'll have to incorporate those recommendations in their revised proposal. We then enter into contract negotiations, and once everybody is somewhat happy, or nobody is happy, as generally tends to be the case, but we can all get along, and for the greater good, we can sign off on contract negotiations, and the contracts are signed, and the institutes are ready to go on. So, as I said, Rory is going to give a small demonstration of FlexiGrant and a quick run through on it. So I'm sure you have questions, but we might hold off on the questions until Rory's finished, and then we can leave all the questions till the end, if that's okay. So I'll just ask Rory to guide us through FlexiGrant.